everybody, and welcome back to the Aeon Only Challenge. Nah. That's gonna be a hard intro. Anyway, welcome back. It's been a little bit of a hot minute, you could say. Just a little bit, maybe. But we're back. I uninstalled a few things, so we have space. We're able to play this and able to keep it going until that upgrade happens, which is maybe 2 weeks away from uploading this. So not too bad, but it's still going to be a while. So as we know, in the last episode, we were on a boat, we took out our first boss, and we basically got to know the ropes. In this one, we're in a big, destroyed city, and we get to listen to a few bits of story, bit of lore. I'm still wondering how to fully do this series, if I'm honest. How I did it in the last episode, I think, might be the best way, where we just kind of show the actual challenge parts and maybe a little bit of story for context. A lot of the really hard parts of this challenge don't come until later. One of the hardest things right now is that our Aeons, we can't currently teach any abilities. Later on, we can teach our Pokemans abilities. But as of this moment, we currently can't. And we also only have one, but we end up with quite a few more. Including some secret ones that I'm definitely going out of my way to go get. Some of the hardest parts of this game will be when we cannot use them, because the challenge would have been Aeons only, but there are some scripted parts where under no circumstance can we use the Aeons unless we cheat. I don't really know how to cheat, otherwise I would do that. There's some scripted underwater fights where you cannot summon. There's some parts where you're just not allowed to summon. And that's why everyone is going to stay level 1, except for Yuna, which is the person that summons our Pokemans. So I'm thinking we're going to skip ahead to the start of the next fight. Maybe I'll show some farming, anything that really happens. But yeah, right now it's just pretty simple. So we're going to keep going about it this way, where I'll show the cutscene beforehand and after a boss, and maybe some farming here and there, because I'm still trying to figure out, I'm still testing the waters, you could say, of how to do this series. But you guys be sure and let me know what you'd prefer. Would you prefer I just show everything, or would you prefer how I'm doing it, or would you prefer we just boss to boss to fight? Technically, if we did it that way, it'd be the quickest progress, but I'm sure some of you guys want a little bit of context, not just like, we're fighting person A. Who is he? You'll never know. but let me know. I mean, if you guys want me to do that, I'll do that. But for right now, we're just going to show a bit of story, the boss, and then we'll be good to go. So, I'll see you in the next area. Yo, what is up? There was a bit of a time skip, and now we got the whole squad in the jungle.
What's up?
Yuna's saying she wants you with us.
Huh?
I want to ask you to be my guardian.
You know what? There's no time for jokes, yeah? He may be a blitzball whiz kid, but up against fiends, he's a newbie.
Not a guardian, then. I just want him nearby.
Well,
What? What do you mean?
It's just that... Well... We're all going to the temple anyway. Can't this wait till later? I'm sorry. I shouldn't have...
There's nothing to be sorry about. I'm just not really sure what's going on.
My apologies.
Something is written here. That's a language we don't understand yet. Alright. We are in free roam mode. Basically, we're free to do whatever we want. So for a sake, of course, we're going to do. So we're going to go loot. There are random monsters around, so randomly the screen will shatter into a million pieces.
Kimari, why don't you use Lancet on it?
What's a Lancet?
Normally, it's a skill that weakens enemies and heals the user. But when a Ronso uses it, that Ronso can sometimes learn Fiend's abilities.
Hey, sounds cool!
Alright! Now, I have to remember how to, We don't want to use any of these weak characters. Okay, I didn't one-shot it. I'm actually a bit surprised. So, what she does, she being the giant bird on the screen, she has sonic wings, which, as it says, damages an enemy, delays its turn. Very useful. A few black magic spells, nothing crazy. And then just a basic attack. We are going to use sonic wings. Easy peasy. Now there is a way to to make the Aeon summon a lot shorter, which you just go into settings and then Aeon's short. Saves a lot of time. So we're gonna do that because as cool as the summons are, when we're only using them, it can get a little bit frustrating, we'll say. That's a shortened one. So much faster. Alright. Now...
Be strong.
I always forget that they have little phrases they'll say at the start of battles, or at the end of battles. But they'll say things randomly. So Aeons have a built-in scanner. What that means is they can see info about enemies. They can see weaknesses, health, little tooltip. So, for example, yellow element right there is weak to water. My controller, there we go. So we're gonna use water on him. We are! Alright. Now, he's just really fast, so we're just gonna... Overkill is when you do so much damage, you overkill them. It makes them drop more monies and more goodies. We're gonna use Ice. Or excuse me, Blizzard. So far, so smooth. We're also gaining a lot of spheres, not that we really need them because we're already, like, overloaded. These are protector people. We Crusaders are training for the upcoming operation. Call on us if you see any sin spawn. That is like the thing we fought on the boot. Now there's multiple paths. There's also a lot of enemies. I've been going for the weakness, but honestly, with the Aeon, you could probably just whack them a few times and they'll just be dead. There is a mini-boss sitting around here, which we're gonna fight as soon as we can get to. That's gonna hurt. Ow! Gonna use Sonic Wings. Puts a turn back. Not that it... could we overkill? Let's see. Nope. Ah, the elementals have a bit too much defense for that. Yay! We leveled up. Scout! Forget exactly what that does, but we're gonna attempt to heal. When you touch this, all of your mana and health goes back to full. Alright, now we're gonna go for the mini-boss of the area. You could always cheese. Well, I say cheese. You could always plow through fights and bosses and stuff, but I think we're actually going to if we can help it, not use the overdrive of the Aeon yet, because at this stage of the game, the overdrive is like a one-hit kill to everything. So, as you saw in the last episode, it one-shot the boss. So, now the bees tend to poison you, but our Aeon is immune to status effects. Most, at least. Hooray! Getting more spheres, except we're currently still max on them.
Company, halt!
The fiend before us is Ochu, Lord of the Wood. We've had trouble with this one before. Remember, discretion is the better part of valor.
We, however, are ready for
standing guard, sir.
For this Ochu character.
The Ochu is no garden variety fiend. We could throw 100 crusaders at it and still lose.
The difference between them and me is I have a giant bird. Okay, so, Ochu is your first huge test, I want to say. Weak to fire, but a massive amount of health. Ochu also has a move that puts all of your people to sleep, and a move that can poison everyone. So, Ochu is no joke. However, we have fire. Ochu does a lot of damage. We're basically just gonna spam fire on him, though. And he's gonna spam water on us, apparently. I'm not sure if we're gonna be able to kill. It's actually gonna be close. Can we push him back? We can. Let's push him back a little bit. We want to try and get as many hits in as possible. Keep pushing it back. You can technically do this until he just takes his turn regardless. So we'll see how far along we can get until he forces his turn. It's not the best damage, but it is starting to become less effective. The little bar on the top right is telling us that, see that little line that moves right next to boss? That's telling you how far it pushes back, but it is slowly getting less and less effective. I mean, we might just kill him before then. We'll see, but it seems to be working out for us. So he if we didn't have this again, he would take his turn right now. But we're just gonna push back again. One more time! Alright, now we're gonna go for an overkill. 400 damage! Did not get the overkill, but we did get Lord Ochi down. Hooray!
A summoner and her guardians. Very impressive.
Sir, we should fight too.
We'll get our chance soon enough.
Young crusaders gather around. We'll beat sin into the ground.
Well, they seem nice. I'm gonna run back and heal real fast. We have healed. We're gonna explore to the right, because I believe there's a bit of goodies back here. Oh, there's another fight back here. You dare! You will pay! It's very satisfying to only use the hands, I gotta tell you. We did not level up. However, we do still have a level up just sort of sitting around, so I'll show you how that kind of works. So, we have one level. What that means, we can either move back I guess technically four spaces. How do I explain this properly? You can either move back four spaces for places you've already moved, or you can move forward one space. So we move forward one space. There's no node, but you can, with your spheres, with your spheres, you can use, and depending on what's around, you can use the spheres that are around. There's nothing currently around, but for example, if we wanted to use this defense sphere, we would go, okay, let's see here. Let's use this power sphere, and that'll activate the defense sphere. And, this HP node. We want to use the power sphere, boom, we get some more HP. Does that make sense? I'm trying to simplify it. It is a bit of a confusing system, but that's alright. We're gonna head this way. Trying to explore everything this jungle's got for us. Hello. I believe we've already explored... Like I was saying, I'm not sure if we've explored this way. Okay, we already have. Okay. That's basically everything the jungle has to offer. There might be a secret or two around. Many fiends have been sighted in the area attacked by Sin. Please be careful on your journey. Hey, thank you. Oh. Okay. That's gonna happen a lot, which is why this game is a wee bit on the difficult side to record. Lux Sphere! That's gonna be a good one. That is crit, dodge... Yeah, crit and dodge, basically. Maybe accuracy? I'm not sure. We're heading back this way, because this is the correct way to go. Any goodies here? No? Alright, now we did get another level, so we're going to move. Let me move down. Here we go. Yeah. So now, because we're directly next to it, we can activate this HP sphere. Boosh! 200 more HP, which is like 20 more for our Aeon. I'm not sure exactly how the stat sharing works.
Oh! These stone steps have a history, you know. Yep. Lord O'Holland trained here at his peak.
A race, huh? Think you can beat me?
Yuna, if you would.
Ready!
Hey!
Ah, huh? Hey!
What do they have to say? Nothing. He still doesn't like us very much.
Kids.
Look out!
Everyone, quick! Sin spawn!
But instead of using the actual fighters, we're gonna summon our girl! Because yes, this is a girl. I believe. I just assumed a gender! Okay. So, the strategy for this fight, I believe you wanna take out the tentacles first. So we're gonna do that. Not quite dead, very low. Good miss. We have a fairly high dodge chance. So we just avoided both of those. We're going to take out this one. We are! One down. Ow! Ow. Now the bad thing about the Aeon currently is we can't teach her any healing spells. So any damage she takes is... That was a crit and overkill. Wow. Any damage she takes is relatively permanent. Now, this boss is weak to fire, and killing the tentacles allows you to use magical attacks against him. However, now he's out of his shell. He's still weak to fire, so we're going to go ahead and keep using fire against him. Now this will poison normally, but luckily, our Aeon is immune. We're gonna see if we can try and... Gonna go for fire. Just because I don't want to cheese him too bad. Elemental damage. Ow. Wow. You don't have a very high, You sure don't do a lot of damage, do you? Go for a physical attack. Staccato! Ow, 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 ow. Alright. We're gonna go for the overkill. We want that extra loot. God dang! Yeah, that's why we're not relying on overdrives.
Yeesh.
Sorry about that. Hope to break you in a little slower.
Being a guardian's tiring.
You handle yourself pretty well. You got talent.
Hey. So, what are these sin spawn anyway?
Fiends. They fall from Sin's body and are left behind in its wake.
Leave him alone and Sin comes back for him. You gotta be quick.
That moment when Waka told me I had talent in battle, I think that was when I started seriously considering becoming a guardian.
Oh, I'm far away from leveling! We did get quite a bit of goodies, though. Now, I don't believe there's anything in this little arena. We're gonna run back and save. Onwards we go!
Huh.
So, they got fiends in Xenarcan too?
Just a few. It's a big deal when one shows up, though. Hey, since one of you believed me about Xanarkin anyway?
I've been thinking. Maybe people Sin gets to don't die. Maybe Sin carries them through time, like 1,000 years through time. And then one day, maybe they just pop back, see?
Amazing. Simply amazing.
Hmm?
You make up one theory after another, refusing to face the simple truth. Sin didn't take Chapu anywhere. Sin crushed him and left him on the Jose shore. Your brother won't just pop back. Oh, and one more thing. No matter how much you want it, no one can take Chapu's place. No one can replace Sir Jekt, for that matter. And there's no replacement for Lord Braska, either. It's pointless to think about it. And sad.
I could never be what Chapu was. Well, stuff happens. Best not to worry.
Waka, Lulu, and Waka's brother, Chapu. Something had happened between them a long time ago. I was sure of it. Well, whatever it was none of my business, that's for sure. Best not to go there.
This is the second temple. The first temple is where we got our dear old bird. So, connecting the dots, pretty sure this is where we're gonna get our second bird.
I heard famous people come here. Where could they be?
You're looking at them. We've decided to leave Killica and look for a place without Sin. Who knows if we'll ever find it.
I've had enough of Killica. Too many tearful memories here, there. We came to visit the temple one last time before we leave for good.
Anyone else around? Hello.
I hear the Crusaders are going to fight Sin without the aid of a summoner. They've got another thing coming. Haven't they ever heard of divine retribution? Like, dude.
So this is a place honored in remembrance of High Summoner O'Holland. Makes you kind of nervous, y'all.
You sure are a talented man, playing blitzball and fighting like that.
These are fantastic voices I've given them.
I'm going to pray real hard so that Sin doesn't come back here.
Climbing those steps every day has kept me in shape. Haven't caught a cold in years.
You here to pray for victory, too?
Us pray? Who needs to pray? The Luka-goers always win.
Oh, yeah? Then why are you here?
We've been praying for some competition this year.
So what's your goal this time? You gonna do your best again?
Ha! It's too bad your best isn't good enough.
Why even bother showing up? This time, we play to win.
Ooh, play away.
Just remember, even kids can play, boys.
See you in the finals!
We'll beat them. We have to.
You know that team?
Putting people down? They're as bad as my old man.
But Sir Jekt was a kind and gentle man.
Well, not my Jekt. Even 10 years after he left. Just thinking about my old man got me angry. But maybe that was just my way of keeping him... Nah.
I'm not sure if there's any looties around, so we're just gonna give a quick little check here.
May the Killika Beasts win this year's tournament and serve as a sign of encouragement and hope for the people of Killika.
Killika Temple is the Temple of Fire. Even the Cloister of Trials is engulfed in flames. Those who disobey the precepts and enter unsanctioned may forfeit their lives.
I don't believe there's any loot around, but we're just gonna spam A on everything. Is there anything around we can pick up? No, there's not. Checking the second door just real quickly.
I'm supposed to study real hard. I'm supposed to study. I'm supposed to study real hard and become a nun. But I want to run around and play at the beach.
You.
Guess what? I really like studying the scriptures. The monks give us lots of sweets if we study hard.
Adorable. Anything around? Anything around. Spam A. Spam A on it all. Look at it all. There's nothing. Well, that was very enlightening. Thank you, dear children.
I envy your happy-go-lucky attitude.
Yeah, once we win the tournament, this will be my victory pose.
Hello.
I think Waka needs to do a little more praying. Please, let Waka's prayers be heard.
What about Blue Man, Kamari? Nope, still says nothing.
Lord O'Holland, guide our feet.
We'll pray with him. Make the whole group happy.
A summoner, are you?
My name is Yuna, from the Isle of Bisaid.
Donna? So, you're High Summoner Braska's daughter. That's quite a name to live up to. My, my, my. And all these people are your guardians? My, what a rabble. As I recall, Lord Braska had only two guardians. Quality over quantity, my dear. Whatever were you thinking? I have need of only one guardian. Right, Bartello?
I only have as many guardians as there are people I can trust. I trust them all with my life. To have so many guardians is a joy and an honor. Even more so than being my father's daughter. Of course, I would never think of questioning your ways either. So, Lady Donna, I ask of you, please leave us in peace.
You do what you want, Bartello, we're leaving.
A guardian is someone a summoner can rely on. Someone she can trust with her life. I wondered, did Yuna feel that way about me? What's she smiling about?
Alright. We're gonna end it right here, right before the second temple puzzle. hope you guys enjoyed this one. I left in a lot more story. So, in the last one, it was a little story, a boss, and then it was basically over. In this one, a bit more variety. So, maybe in the next one, we'll only show fights. I don't know. Still testing the waters. But, let me know what you thought about this one. And if you like the whole, a bit more quantity over quality. No. but yeah, just let me know which format you like. Would you prefer only the fights, a little story, boss, a little more story, or would you prefer it more how we did it this way, which is a lot more story, I'd say more fights sprinkled in, but overall, this one was more story than fights, I think. But thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.